What? Luchini pouring from the sky, let's get rich. What? The Jiki finds a sugar dance, can't quit. What? Now pop the cork and see the Vega and get lit. What? 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 Introducing Phantom of the Dark, walk through my heaven with levitation from Christian Chenji, Benzini, Seven, showboating with Rugas, Flash Vines, Belafonte, Digger, Landscape for what this worth as we confiscate your figures.
Chasing over brown, levitating, Jiki and Dashiki's the Lahada car, 54, chasing diamond runners, headed ice band, the big chiller diamond convention, Harlem Buck Strut, Reason World Heist, Hollywood, Madam Butterfly, let me in your house, a pleasure, from the knuckle swatch, shadow boxes catching black eye blue.
I play the thief, what? Sensations at the Monte Gras, we screaming. Fulfilling pleasures in my castles, blow the smoke out. The Garza Vega substitutes when the Dutch is gone. The load don't stop, give me shouts, it's the season. Sauteas, souffleas for swerving no corners. We magnets to moolah, living with Charlie's Angels on us. No smiling, we're sliding. That gets you caught up in the octa or dead if we're moving. It's just like that as we proceed.
Saturday night. Better take it light, you Jaja, you're the Capitan. Quest to the coast, the Key Largo, wire the chain gang. Keep your ears out for our ears, sip the fountain blue, house of bamboo, paradise.
This is it, what? Luchini pouring from the sky, let's get rich, what? The Jiki finds a sugar dime, can't quit, what? Now pop the cork, it's Nina Vega and get lit, what? This is it, what? This is it, what? Luchini pouring from the sky, let's get rich, what? The Jiki finds a sugar dime, can't quit, what? Now pop the cork, it's Nina Vega and get lit, what? What? What?
Fallen sparrows, courtesies of Black Caesar, the convincer, silky days, satin nights, taking flight, Dino going, sweet sensation, Spanish flying with the ladies, far face, bottoms up, sunshine, love pushing them.
Man, Big Mike back there. A little interview.
A little time.
I'm going to keep it 100 now.
Go keep it 100.
I'm going to keep it 100.
You promise?
I'm going to try.
I was trying. Hey, check this out, man. This is for my partners right here, Mackcity Limits Radio Show, man. A while back, man, when you was doing your thug thizzle on The Walking Dead.
Mm-hmm.
All right, first of all, let me introduce my man. This is Big V Ward.
What up, though?
Vincent Ward, the next big thing.
Yeah.
And, you know, I let Cass know. He's like, yeah, man, my partner, man, he got a little gig on The Walking Dead, man. They was like, for real? Like, yeah, man, that nigga. Yeah, it's Oscar. Oscar on The Walking Dead. They was like, you don't know that, nigga. You don't know that, nigga. I'm like,
they
man.
Mike been knowing each other for who knows how long. We have seen ups, we've seen downs, we've cracked up, we've laughed, we've loved each other, we've been best friends from friends, we've been brothers for, man, how long?
Man, since, shoot, your junior high days, man. My,
wow.
Yeah, you know, I think I just, yeah, what's up, junior Charles? High, junior high.
Yeah, since junior high. I mean, shoot. It's like we rekindled over these last couple months.
Shoot,
that's
boy.
That's my guy. You ain't got a lie to kick it.
Yeah, I heard that, man. But yeah, this going out to all my partners, man. That was just,
I don't know, they was acting like you was Robert De Niro or something, man. Yeah. It's like, ah, oh, you don't know that brother, man. I'm like, yeah, that's my partner, man. We came up in the game.
And that's the killer thing about it. It's like, why somebody have to lie about knowing somebody?
Uh-huh.
See, but that goes back to the whole mentality of this dating mentality. People don't think that you can get up out of here and do something with your life.
Right.
And don't think that you can grow up with somebody and know them.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the way that somebody might look at me is not the same way you look at me because you know what we go through or what we've been through.
Right. Mm-hmm. I couldn't understand it. I'm like, man, but like I told you, one of my partners, man, to this day, every time you see you in a commercial, the brother, man, he pick up the phone and call me. Yeah, I see your boy, man. I see your boy in the commercial. I was like, boy, he more hyped to see you in the commercials than me, man. And, you know, to me, that's kind of like, that's a good thing. That's a very good thing, man,
right,
to see one brother glad that another brother is actually doing something and making it. You know what I mean? Because you meet a lot of haters out here, man, that
oh, yeah,
kind of downplay what you're doing and what you're into, man. So, mm-hmm, yeah, so I got cats out there, man, that actually, they don't know you, but they follow you, you know, just because on the strength that I know you.
Well, you know, hey, man, but you know what, though, Mike? You know, man, you've been talking about this for the last couple of days.
Right.
Support is key.
Right.
You know, and for somebody who don't even really know me, supporting me and showing you love on the strength of me,
right,
I appreciate it, man, because
yeah,
you got people that you and grew up with, kicked it with, dated,
mm-hmm,
played ball with, don't support you.
Right.
You know, and I think that's kind of sad that, you know, we talked about this on the way over here.
Okay.
That I feel like my premiere, my movie premiere, it should have been packed.
Yeah.
It should have been jam packed.
No doubt.
But I've learned that your hometown don't support you.
No.
Like they should. But they support somebody that they don't know more than they support somebody that they've been knowing for years. Mm-hmm. And I think that's kind of sad. But like my dad told me, the Troutmans and Ohio players, all of them felt the same way.
Mm-hmm.
But yet, we let Popeye's Chicken or Chick-fil-A have a damn chicken sale. The line is around the corner. You know, let Dave Chappelle and Kanye West come. The line is around the corner, but yet you couldn't come spend $20, which some of the money was going towards the victims of the tornado.
Right, right, right.
But yet you want to say that we friends? How are we friends? Right. I think that the word friend is used too loosely.
Okay.
I think people rather brag about them knowing you
mm-hmm.
than really supporting you.
Yeah, that's a wild thing, man, because I've been seeing those memes of them chicken sandwiches.
Mm-hmm.
Man, I've been seeing cats retweet that stuff and repost that stuff. Man, I didn't see that much enthusiasm about the Mirror Mirror joint.
Right.
You know what I mean? Your movie.
Right.
You know, cats was going way overboard, man, just going all out for the chicken sandwiches.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I'm like, damn, really, bro?
But I see those same people waiting in line 2 or 3 hours to sit out in the hot sun for a concert mm-hmm. and they ain't even near the damn stage. Mm-hmm. Those people don't know you. Those
right.
people, you know, I got people here in Dayton that call me up, you know, can you talk to my son? Can you talk to my daughter? You know, how can they get in acting? How can they do this? How can they do that? But yet when I come home, you don't hear from them.
Right.
And I'm tired mm-hmm. of that crap.
Mm-hmm.
I'm tired of it.
Yeah.
I mean, that's why I'm gonna tell you right now, because I know a lot of people is listening right now
okay.
on social media, on Facebook, from Dayton.
Right.
That's why my Dayton list is a lot smaller
mm-hmm.
from Thursday.
Okay.
And I'm just going to keep it 100. Because
right.
if we can't be real with each other, we can't be supportive of one another,
mm-hmm.
then what are we really truly doing?
Mm. Mm.
I think it's sad.
Well, black folks got a big problem with clout chasing, man. You know what I mean? As long as the magic rub off on them,
mm-hmm.
you know what I mean? It's kind of like a situation where they don't want to help nobody build nothing. You know, they want to be cool with you when your empire's already built.
Right.
You know what I mean? They don't want to put in no blood, sweat, and tears, or no work to help someone they know or someone they supposed to love get there.
Right.
You know what I mean? Like
right.
I said, they just clout chasing. You know, they just want that notoriety of knowing that they know somebody.
You know, but the thing about me, Mike, man, I don't do anything for people to say, oh, I did this for you. I did that for you.
Right.
I did that for your kid. I never do anything. I don't ask for anything in return. But damn, it's just like the school supply thing.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we giving out free school supplies, backpacks to people. That place, it should have been packed.
Right.
It should have been packed. But
mm-hmm.
no, let such and such who don't live here do something like that.
Mm-hmm.
Everybody breaking their neck to do it.
Mm-hmm.
Mirror, mirror. Should have been packed. Thank
right.
you to the people who did come, though.
Right.
I don't get it.
Mm.
I don't care how many interviews I do. I always represent where I come from.
Right.
Trotwood, Dayton. And I'm so passionate about it, man. Mm-hmm. You know, but it gets to the point, it's just like, come on, dude.
Mm.
Come on.
Well, Dick, before you did this, because when you brought it up to me, I thought it was going to be suicide, man, because I'd always heard that local artists gets no love from their hometown.
Mm.
You had never heard this before?
Oh, I definitely heard it. And that was definitely one of my biggest concerns.
But you still went ahead with it and said, let's get it, let's do it.
Yeah, because we start hitting every city.
Mm-hmm.
You know, we're hitting a lot of cities. But I guarantee you, somebody
mm-hmm.
in Dayton, Ohio, probably said, oh, he probably ain't gonna come here. And the
mm-hmm.
person who said it, probably didn't even come to the premiere anyway.
Okay.
And I don't get it. It's like people are quick to talk about you, but
mm-hmm.
they ain't quick to support what you're doing.
Right.
And mm-hmm. I don't get it.
I was kind of disappointed, man. Like I said, I got there and I was just like, man, there should be a lot more people. Well, actually, as the night went on and more people was filtering in, mm-hmm. you know, I'm thinking to myself, well, this is much better. But every seat in that joint, man, should have been, you know, occupied, man. There's no doubt about that, man. And for everybody that didn't come, you missed a good one, man, because we discussed this, right, man, but...
Keep it 100.
But everybody... Every time I see my boy V acting in whatever he's in, it's just always hilarious to me. It's always funny. Even when he's doing something dramatic and stuff. It's just, so I enjoyed myself thoroughly, man. Even my lady friend, she enjoyed it too, man. So yeah, y'all missed a good one, man. It's just sorry y'all ain't come out and support my boy, man.
But you know what? I look at it like this. The people who were there was the people that were supposed to be there.
Right.
You know, it was a message in the film that some folks really and truly needed to hear.
Yeah.
You know, you can't. When people see me, I don't want them to see the old Vincent. Not saying the old Vincent, something was wrong.
Right.
You know, but I'm more humble now than I ever been in my life. Mm-hmm. And it's not about my career. It's about who I am as a person.
Mm-hmm.
You know, everything ain't peaches and cream. You know, I wish I had a better relationship with my kids.
Right.
But you know what? There's nothing you can do mm-hmm. to change people's minds, especially as adults. You know, my mm-hmm. focus is on being a better me, being a better father, better grandfather, a better son, you know, a better role model. I want to take that position as a role model to be able to come back to my hometown and give back. But it's hard to come back and give back when people, I don't want to say nobody's hating. I don't mm-hmm. want to say nobody's jealous. But I know some people that's actors or mm-hmm. in the acting game now,
right,
that should have been there.
Mm-hmm.
If you're a real actor and actress, why not come and meet some fellow actors and actresses mm-hmm. that's doing it? Why not come meet Bishop Wynn that owns a network?
Mm-hmm.
You know, how you know he's not auditioning for his next thing?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? But yet you have people contact me on a low
mm-hmm.
because you don't want to do it. But damn, we're supposed to be cool.
Mm.
I think people base my career ahead of the person.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Because okay. It's just like, I haven't changed.
Mm-hmm. But no, you sure ain't. You sure ain't changed. We need to keep your mouth shut sometimes, man. You always talking crazy to my grandmama, man. Hey, he told my grandmama he sell dope. She asked you, she's like, so what you been doing these days, Vincent?
I said a little dope here and there.
Like, man, don't be scaring my grandmama like that.
But the thing about it, Mike, that's me. You know, I love to come back and see my old neighbors.
Yeah.
You know, I love to come back and check on people's parents and grandparents because everybody's getting older now.
Right.
You know, mm-hmm. my parents is getting older. Mm-hmm. What up, though? My parents is getting older. It's probably somebody who didn't come to the premiere right here, but they hollering at me. My parents is getting older, so you know, it's time for people to just really and truly start putting people ahead of themselves.
Mm-hmm.
What up, man? Doing the interview.
What's going on?
Yeah, man.
Back home
to the city, man. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Mm-hmm. Hold on.
Pause.
Oh, my fault. What's up, man? Good to see you.
I'm right here, brother. How you doing?
We good, man. Just doing this podcast and this live. Though. It went well. Okay. It went well.
Okay. Yeah.
That's yeah.
What part of California you in?
L.A.
Yep. I'm about to move to Nevada.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm moving there. Matter of fact, I'm moving in 2 weeks.
All right, get ready for that hot weather.
Yeah, man. Shit. Anything better than this.
Yeah, man.
Anything better, but good to see you.
Yeah, bro, let me know when you get out there, because I'm out in Nevada a lot.
Okay, yeah, like I said, I'm gone, man. I'm up out of here, man. You know,
I'm trying to turn the
city on, man. You know, I have my little event and thing and try to turn the city on, man.
Right.
Like 13 people show up, you know.
Wait a second. Wait. Time out, man.
Y'all hear that? So what do you do?
I give people new credit files. You know?
Okay.
And what I was turning the city on, man, I'm showing everybody how to get this money. You know what I'm saying? We ain't got to worry about you know, the banks giving us the loans, you know, this, you know what I'm saying? But what I do, man, I was turning the whole city on to it. What I do, man, I charge $5,000.
Okay.
I was giving it away for $250 to my city.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Because I know we hurt. I know our pockets is, you know, I messed up. We done been through, you know, tornadoes. We done been through, you know, all types of, you know, tragedies. But it's sad, man. You know
so
what
you
I'm saying?
Said you didn't get no support from your people?
I made 13 people millionaires. You know what I'm saying? As opposed, I could have did the whole city.
Right.
You know what I'm
saying?
My thing was the whole city come on out. You know, I had comedians, free food, liquor, everything. You know what I'm saying?
See, that's one thing that we just got.
We just talking about that.
It's, people, I honestly got this saying, I'd rather for you to treat me like you don't know me than you do know me. Because sometimes people treat people better that they don't know.
And it's true. You know, I go to Atlanta. And man, I got the packed house, people I ain't never seen in my life.
Right.
You know, 400 or 500 people ready. You know what I'm saying? But I come home and I had 1,500 people, person that I knew, friends, families, you know what I'm saying, that I knew, that they know me.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? But it's like, oh, Aaron, you know, and it's crazy, man.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Like, I don't get no support from my own city. You know what I'm saying?
Look at that. What's the odds of that?
And I'm on tour. You know what I'm saying? I'm on tour. I got 25 people states waiting for me. You know what I'm saying? But before I left, I said, you know what? I want to do something for my city. You know what I'm saying? Let me turn on, because I don't want to be that person on TV or when y'all see me on the Breakfast Club and they be like, oh, man, that's Aaron from Dayton. He didn't come through or holler at the city. You know what I'm saying? But I did. You know what I'm saying? So when y'all do see me there, y'all can't say, hey, man, that was my first tour.
Yeah, but these are the same type of dudes that are hollering and screaming that you ain't give back to the community and all that.
All that. Then, after they see what I'm doing, oh, man, give me the hook up.
Right.
It's like, why
you got to prove yourself first? I mean, I've already proved yourself. What else you want me to do? I'm not jumping through no hoops and loops, kissing nobody's butt.
It's crazy.
To respect me or like me.
We don't support our own, man. They talking about dating strong. How can we be dating strong when everybody hating on each other? Don't nobody want to see nobody support nobody's success. You know what I'm saying? It's crazy, man.
You would be surprised how many people I've had who have my number called me and be like, hey, man, tell my girl I know you.
Yeah.
And just put her on the phone. Yeah. It's like, yeah, I know him.
Yeah.
But yet, when I come home, I don't hear from you.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, let
Kanye come to the city.
Uh-oh.
Or
that's exactly what we've been talking
about. They're going to get outfits and jumping through hoops.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? But I'm trying to change a life financially.
Mm-hmm.
Something that's going to change. Something that the president ain't doing. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
But y'all want to come support
that. Gonna promote. You know
what I'm
saying?
Y'all want to come support. Y'all want to go to the Dave Chappelle and let him crack
been
jokes.
Promote.
But he going back home to his $1 million house.
Yeah.
And his lifestyle. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
And, you know, but it's cool, man. I'm just glad my brother
good
here.
To see you, brother.
You know what I'm saying? We grew up four houses down from each other. You know what I'm saying? Tropwood. You know what I'm saying? Silver Note. That's my stuff.
Yeah. You let those stuff on too.
Yeah. Damn, man. You
what's
four houses down? Shoot, I didn't go to Trotwood though. Shoot.
What up, Todd?
Shoot, Mike.
What you stay by the Gilberts? Remember the Gilberts, Rhonda?
I just stayed right across the street from V.
Yeah, he was right across.
Yeah, I'm right there on the corner.
Okay, then.
Up and up, right there on the corner.
Okay.
The corner house.
Yeah, wow, man.
Good seeing y'all.
Likewise,
man.
Bro.
Stay up,
man. Nice success in Vegas, man.
Right. You know, I'm coming, big dog.
Yes, sir.
What's the odds of that?
This ain't phony. This is real.
Damn, man.
I was like, are you serious?
Shoot. So let me ask you this, man. You have issues here with not getting support. Now, wherever you go anywhere else.
Like, so where are you based out of, LA?
Yeah.
All right. So what's the support like there with your fellow actors or directors or producers who are black? Do you have the same sort of problem there as far as support is concerned?
Whatsoever, no.
Because
everybody knows how important it is to support each other.
Okay.
You know, you don't want to do a play or whatever and not have nobody there.
Okay.
You don't want to have a premiere and nobody is there.
Mm-hmm.
It's just like what he was just saying,
right.
Him having his thing.
Mm-hmm.
But the key thing about it is he knew about my thing.
Right.
So how you gonna complain about nobody showing up to your thing?
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean?
Okay.
It's just like, if we that cool, we grew up together.
Okay.
Why you didn't come to mine?
Right, okay, I got you.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I mean, some people online said they didn't know anything about it. No, he talking to, I didn't hear about this. Some people said they didn't hear about it, but anytime it was on my page,
mm-hmm.
all day, every day. I honestly, man, Mike, if it wasn't for my career,
right,
I wouldn't be on social media.
Right.
Because I never want anybody to feel like I'm bragging and boasting about what I've accomplished.
Right.
The Walking Dead, mm-hmm. if I could, I would shut that down.
Okay.
But I can't do anything about it.
All right.
You know what I mean? Acting is what I do. It's not who I am.
Mm-hmm.
Get to know who I am.
Right, right.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
You know, I don't like to keep on, I focus on what I'm trying to do in the future.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever I've done in the past, that's in the past.
Mm.
You know?
Okay. Well, let me ask you this, man, pertaining to your work.
Do you have any particular favorite movie or piece of work that you've done that you would basically elevate above everything that you've done so far?
Well, of course I got to say The Walking Dead.
Okay.
Because nobody leave that alone. But I've done...
No, ain't.
Right.
Which is my favorite.
Right, okay. Right. I just did a play with Snoop, man.
Oh, really?
The Redemption of the Dog. And I've done a lot of plays, a lot of theater. It was Snoop, myself, Tamar Braxton, Omar Gooding, Demetri McKinney, Eric Benet, Lil JJ, my boy Billy. Man, I mean... It was off the chain. We didn't come to Dayton, but we came close to Dayton.
Okay.
Shouts out to everybody who came to Cleveland and Detroit to watch it.
Okay.
And I had a great time working on Everybody Hates Chris,
mm-hmm.
you know, with Terry Crews and mm-hmm. Tashina Arnold. I learned a lot from them. Honestly, man, I can't really put my finger on one thing, because as an actor and actress, you're just grateful to be working.
Yeah. Okay.
You know, because you don't know where your next job is coming from.
All right.
You know, a lot of people be like, oh man, you made it. You doing it. What am I doing?
Mm-hmm.
What, you don't think I ain't got no problems? You don't think I got no bills?
Right.
Yeah. I ain't where I want to be, but guess what? I ain't where I used to be.
Right.
Because a lot of people quit this industry because they wanted it too fast or, you know, they want to do something strange for a little piece of change. And I'm not doing that, man.
Mm-hmm.
I'd rather sit there, be patient, keep my faith, keep praying, and when it happens, it happens. But what exactly is making it?
Oh. Okay, I'm about to ask you something. It's gonna be deep now. We're gonna see where your head is at. You ready?
Yep.
If I came to you and I said, if you put on this dress, I'm gonna make you Kevin Hart status, nigga. Would you put that dress on?
If they changed the character to Mama Sally, I could act like my grandmother, probably. Because but you have to think of it like this.
Uh-huh.
When I'm killing somebody, that ain't who I am.
Okay.
You know, when I'm doing this and doing that ain't who I am.
Right.
The only thing that I wouldn't do
is
I wouldn't have a sex scene or kiss another man.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
I'm not gonna do that. You know, it's enough of that in the world right now.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you can turn on the commercials and see that. It's nothing against my gay brothers and sisters. It's just something that I don't want to do.
Right.
And I got grandkids, mm-hmm. and I don't want them to see their granddad doing something like that.
But, and on the real, man, it'd be hard for me to even... I don't even think you put the dress on, man. You say you were contemplating, but I can't even see you put the dress on.
I didn't say I was contemplating nothing. You asked a question.
You know what I'm saying? I've been knowing you way too long, man.
Yeah, like, you know me, man.
Like, I don't know, man.
Me. It's like...
But that's a lot of money, though.
Hey, you can look at Tyler Perry McNeil. But if I was Tyler Perry, boy, that movie would have been packed in Dayton, Ohio.
Yeah, sure would have, man. So, yeah, I'm just trying to figure out.
But let me say this right quick.
Go ahead.
Like, I don't want nobody to think that I'm mad.
Okay.
That I'm bitter.
Okay.
If anything, I was disappointed.
Disappointed. Right.
You know, I mean, each city that we've gone to, it's probably been that amount of people there anyway.
Okay.
But for me, I'm bragging about where I'm from.
Right.
Gym City, Nick.
Right.
Trotwood, Nick. We doing something positive.
Right.
Walk up in there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like, yeah, they on their way.
Right.
But for me to go to school here.
Mm-hmm.
For me, for my parents, my family still live here.
Mm.
You know, it's disappointing.
Right.
Disappointing.
Yeah, it's very disappointing. It's disappointing for me. Now, you know, I ain't got no skin in the game.
I'm thinking 200-300 people going to be there.
Yeah, uh-huh.
You know, but it's all good. If the only thing that did was put more fuel to my fire, mm-hmm. to make me try even harder. I ain't gonna forget where I come from.
Right.
But in the same breath, I'm gonna give you the side eye, mm-hmm. all of them. And like I said, my Facebook friends, the list is smaller than this past couple days. They probably, some of them probably watching right now.
Uh-huh.
But it's all good. Oh, I don't, you don't owe me nothing, and I don't owe you nothing.
Right,
believe
right.
that.
Uh-huh. Well, let me ask you this, because I remember, man, when you came to me, I can't remember what year it was, but it was in Columbus, and you wanted me to film, what was it, man? It was like a gospel play, and you had a very famous singer.
Ooh. Oh, yeah. Ollie Woodson, Vanessa Bell Armstrong,
yeah.
and Keith Washington.
Yeah, man, that was funny, man, because the homeboy was coming at me. Do you remember that, man?
Well, Ollie Woodson.
He didn't want me to film it and all that kind of stuff, man.
What happened was, because Ollie thought we were making money off of it being videotaped.
Right.
And I was telling him, no, this is my homeboy. He has his own station down at
DATV.
Mm-hmm. And he threatened to quit and all types of stuff. And I'm just like, really?
Yeah,
this
man.
We ain't making no money from it. And I still was trying to be respectful and professional, because he was older than
exactly.
me. I respected him as, you know, he used to be in, Papa was a Rolling Stone, one of them groups.
He's very familiar as far as his face.
May he rest in peace. He passed.
Oh, he passed?
Yeah,
okay.
He passed.
Yeah.
And it's just like, I felt like he was basing stuff on money at that time. Mm-hmm.
But you know, that's just a situation where I see what you go through on a regular basis. Just something as simple as that can just kind of like derail everything you're trying to do. You know what mm-hmm. I mean?
Right.
And you know, I don't know, is this something that's indicative of working with black people, or is this all across the board, no matter what nationality that you're working with, white or black?
Well, I haven't ran into that situation with white people.
Okay.
Not saying that they don't do it.
Okay.
I'm sure they do. You know, I've worked on some white projects, and we didn't start on time.
Okay.
You know, everybody think that black projects, you know, runs late and all that other stuff, and that's not the truth.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's about who's the in charge, who's head. You know, that producer that's getting people like, let's go.
Okay.
Let's go. It's just like the movie that I'm working on now, Charm the Hearts of Men. You see what I'm going through with that?
Oh, yeah, got to change your flights and all
right.
that.
Right, keep on to change the flight and all that other stuff. But in the same breath, I'm still grateful. Mm-hmm. I'm still humble, because it could be somebody else.
Right.
You know, and that's how people, that's how in any business, you can be replaced.
Mm-hmm.
Take advantage of the situation that you are in right now. And try to enjoy it, man. There's so much negativity going on in the world.
Mm-hmm.
It's like, who wants to work with somebody who's gonna be a butthole all day?
Mm-hmm.
For instance, I know this one actor. Somebody asked me about them. I said, yeah, you know, he's a great actor.
Mm-hmm.
But can you deal with him after you say cut?
Okay.
Because after you say cut, he's a butt.
Okay.
And if you can't handle the little things, how you expect God to bless you with the big things? Right. If you can't handle this thing, you know?
Okay.
Boy. Well, I don't know, man. Like I said, man, I've been thoroughly enjoying just watching your ride through, man, Hollywood.
Whether it be commercials, sitcoms, movies, mm-hmm. you know what I mean? And I'm proud of you, man. My whole family proud of you. And you know me, man, I don't really be going to see the type of shows that you
right,
be on,
right.
like the Mirror Man, but like I said, support my boy supersedes all that. You know what I mean? I didn't care what the subject matter was. My partner was in it. I'm gonna break bread. I'm gonna go see it. And delightfully, I actually enjoyed it.
Know Mike, you know exactly what he's talking about.
I enjoyed it, man. I was like, man, this was all right, okay.
And the thing about it, Mike, it's like, I appreciate it and I enjoy that you enjoyed it.
Right.
You know, I enjoyed that the people that was there enjoyed the movie, because it's a great movie.
Mm-hmm.
You know, people like, oh, it's faith-based. Give mm-hmm. it a chance.
Right.
Give it a chance, because you'll be surprised. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, it's just like, I felt like everybody from my church should have been there.
Okay. Ah, wow. Okay.
We passed out flyers.
Yeah.
But once again, whoever was there was supposed to be there. And shouts out to the mayor. to Mayor McDonald for coming. You know, when it's time to vote for the Dayton mayor, I think everybody should get out there and vote for her, because what she's doing for Trotwood. Mm. You know, you see her, she's always stepping up and stepping in and helping out and being a voice and a face, and not just talking about it, but being about it. So Dayton, make sure y'all vote for her as a, Trotwood, make sure y'all vote for her when it's time to vote for a new mayor of Dayton.
Okay, well, we're going to wrap this on up, man. We're going on a half hour. Okay. But before we bounce, man, I want you to basically ask, or if anyone was to ask you, what are some key things or key components that a person has to have to make it in the industry as far as acting is concerned, what would you tell them was what's the most important thing to have?
You have to have faith, man.
Okay.
You have to have faith. You have to have patience. Everybody ain't gonna be there for you.
Okay.
Everybody ain't gonna be happy for you.
Right.
Everybody ain't gonna share their knowledge.
Okay.
See, the thing about me, man, I don't mind telling people, hey, such and such having an audition. Hey, okay. Such and such is looking for this. Such and such is looking for that. But I'm only gonna tell you if I know that you got your stuff together.
Okay.
If you don't have your stuff together, I'm not hooking you up on nothing, because you know what? It falls back on me.
Okay.
And you're not gonna make me look bad. So just having faith, having patience, man. Be ready so you don't have to get ready.
Mm-hmm.
And just know, ain't nobody gonna have your back like you.
Yeah.
And you gotta believe in yourself. If you don't believe in yourself, how you expect me to believe in you?
Mm-hmm.
Don't go in there arrogant. Don't go in there conceited. Man, when I first moved to LA, I had already did the movie Traffic with Michael Douglas.
Okay.
I got to LA like, yo, I'm here. I'm doing this. Man, it took me forever to even get an agent.
Man, they ain't get two shits.
None, not two.
Not they like, one. Whatever. Okay.
So.
Yeah, I'm thinking, man, you know, just having a serious work ethic and loving what you do. And that's one thing that I see with you. You love what you do, and that translates into a serious work ethic where you just get tenacious. You know, you get on it like a pit bull and you just don't let go.
Yeah, and to think about it, Mike, if this is a hobby to you,
right.
Don't come in there. Cause this is survival.
This is
what people trying to do for a living.
Doggy dog.
And if it's one word, two words, just like my boy Terrell. Terrell's so humble, man.
Mm-hmm.
He hit me up a couple times. Terrell, we gonna link up when I get home. Mm-hmm. Oh, I said home for LA. Woo!
Oh, uh-oh.
So it's about, you gotta be humble, man.
Okay.
You gotta be humble, you gotta be hungry, but you don't be desperate.
Okay.
You don't kiss nobody's butts, and you don't straddle no fence.
Right.
Because if you do, you sell your soul.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that they might tell you one thing. It might be something totally different after you sell your soul. And I ain't selling mine.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Okay. Well, there we go, man. I appreciate this impromptu
joint,
man. You know, that you're putting together for my players, man. And Dayton, please, man, support your local artists, no matter what they do. Whether it's acting, singing, dancing, rapping, whatever, you know what I mean?
Just hold on, Mike.
Go ahead.
But let me tell you this right quick.
Go ahead.
Break. I saw some people post some stuff today about what you just said, supporting your local artist, your local actor, local everything.
Right.
I know you. I didn't see you Thursday.
Oh, snap.
So don't be just... Every time I want people to know, just because people post something don't mean they keeping it 100.
Okay.
They ain't keeping it 100, man. They doing that stuff to make themselves, so people can like their page and or get more followers and all that.
Mm.
I hate social media.
Mm.
I do.
Right.
But you know what? In this profession, you gotta have it.
Mm-hmm.
You gotta have it. So, man, what's your social media?
My social media?
Yeah.
Well, you can go to, YouTube, go to Mackcity Limits Radio Show. It is not for the faint of heart.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? I talk about a lot of social, economic, political issues and a lot of male-female relationship issues. You know what I mean? So, yeah, go ahead and check that on out.
Yeah.
Like I said, it ain't for the faint of heart, man. It ain't for the faint of heart, boy. I ain't going to tell you about the other stuff, you know, because I'm trying to be good. I'm trying to leave my adult entertainment stuff in the past. You know, I'm trying to follow in the footsteps of my boy Big V and try and be a responsible citizen.
Yeah.
That's right.
Ain't no funny. Everybody out there know, ain't no funny style with me.
Right.
Stop putting the career and judge. It's like they judge me.
Right.
It's like you judge me because you think of, I'm going to be different or, I don't know. I don't get it, man. Mm-hmm. I don't get it. But it's funny. Mm. I put my shoes and socks and drawers on like everybody else. Mm. Like I said, I ain't where I want to be, but I ain't where I used to be. And I know my best is yet to come.
Mm. Oh, yeah, you're going to get there, man. But like I said, I'm just seeing from where you started, and it's a slow, hard grind, man. But you still doing it, man.
It's been times that I wanted to quit, but I was like, I'm too close. So.
And you still got the energy, man, and you still got the enthusiasm. So.
You got to do it.
You know what I mean? All right, man.
All right, bro.
Well, I tell you what. Before you bounce, go ahead and tell cats the latest movie that you're working on and when it's coming out.
I'm working on a movie right now called Charming the Hearts of Men. I don't know when it's coming out.
Okay.
You can catch me on the Win Network. I have a cooking show on there, America's Cooks. I have the Waldens on there. I'm working on my own projects. That's something else that y'all need to start doing. I got a movie and comic book. Based on the character that I created called Devereaux, it's a new age candy man.
Mm-hmm.
I got a traveling show called Conventioning coming out. October, I'll be in Atlanta for Walker Stalker, London for Heroes and Villains. September 22nd, I'll be in Toronto, Canada, Ontario for Movie Expo. That's the thing I was telling you about.
Okay.
I said, get your passport together.
Right.
And yeah, and I'm just gonna continue to be who I am. I'm gonna continue to grow. I'm gonna continue to be a role model. I'm not gonna allow other people stop me from what I'm doing. I'm gonna continue to smile, and I'm gonna keep on moving.
Okay, one more thing.
Yep.
Go ahead, holler at my boy. Say what's up to my boy Rick Nasty. That's my partner. That every time he see you in a commercial, the brother pick up the phone and be like, man, I seen your boy, man. Say what's up to my boy Rick.
Oh, yeah. Family times. Uh-huh. Family times with my boy Omar Gooding on Bounce TV.
Okay.
See, a lot of times I do step up, I don't post it.
Okay.
I catch people off guard.
Okay.
I'm not one of those actors to be like, hey, look at me, I'm on set, or look at me, I have an audition. No, that's not me. I'll hit you in the face with it later on.
Say what's up to Rick.
Hey, pretty Ricky. Rick Nasty, Rick man. Nasty. It's your boy, Big Boy. Yo, you better start believing, Mike. That's my dude, man. That's been my dude for years.
Okay.
And that's his dude. Just walk past. But we here, man. Yo.
Oh, man. It's been a pleasure, man.
Yes, sir.
And things will look up. Trust me.
Most definitely.
We out.
All right, y'all. Peace.
You just don't know what you do to me.
Bad boy. Give me all the chicken heads from Pasadena to Medina. Bet big, get in between your density. Yeah, the prognosis, doses, blends and bends like Twizzlers. Biggest fit into hurt, what's under that skirt?
So that's something to kill.
Who filling them with octane? Got them gassed up, about to get blasted up, son. The last one, heard the mother, brother miss him. I seen it when he kissed him at the wake, made his body shake. The high guy in 850, eyes smoke tint, rap terror, four chrome and terror. Street
like
five by the rivers, the fifth is conspicuous. Bad boy slipped in 95, ridiculous.
Right.
My rap lines is like landmines. One step, kaboom, black suits fill the room. To whom it may concern, Junior Mafia's the clique. I have my honey's total bustle.
That's right.
In the middle of the day now, baby, I seem to think of only you. Oh, oh yeah. Never think of for a moment, baby, that you've been thinking of me too. Yeah. So I can't wait for the day that we can be together.
That's right.
Oh, can't you see?